Namaskar. We are continuing with discussions on Ashtanga Yoga. Today we are talking about pranayama. Prana, yama. Yama, you remember yama nyama? What does it mean? Yama means to control. The effort to control prana. Prana means vital energy. Vital energy that powers our entire body and mind. It has very close, it is a Eastern concept. It's not in the current scientific paradigm, there is no such thing. It is not discovered, the prana within ourselves. But ancient mystics and yogis, they discovered that there is prana. And it is connected with the breath, and it is connected with the state of mind. The mind is connected with prana. The prana vibrates. The yogis describe that prana vibrates. If it pulsates very fast, it is restless. The vital energy is restless within us. So the mind also becomes restless. You see, like children, they're very restless. They may be intelligent, but because of this restlessness, they cannot utilize their intellect so much. And many times that there is the child is very is not studying very well, is very restless. But then after some time he becomes calm. Later on, in the later stage of life, becomes calm, and then he can study very well. So this pranayama, the practice of pranayama, is there to stabilize the mind. For example, you want to imagine a lotus flower with 1,000 petals, for example, to do that. And in that lotus flower, there is something more things there. So how you will do? Okay, 1, 2, 3, everything is gone. You will see that the mind is just fluctuating. It's just you visualize something, and next moment the mind jumps into different direction. Here and there, here and there. So the mind is very, very unstable. It is very difficult, like, for the... You know, in internet, sometimes you get really frustrated. Not now, but before, those people who know the beginnings of internet. Like you are downloading some file. You're downloading, and then stop. And then whole download, you have been downloading 10 megabytes. 5 hours you've been downloading. Then internet connection break, everything gone. So meditation is like that. You are going to download very high, sublime idea. You're downloading. Then your connection is very fluctuating, it's very unstable. It is not very smooth flow of the megabytes going on. So for meditation, it's very important to develop a very, very calm energy. Calm energy and also powerful energy. It has to be very peaceful, but at the same time very, very powerful. Because without energy, it is difficult to meditate. Without energy, it's difficult to have determination, like resolve. I'm going to meditate now, and I'm going to succeed in meditation. If you don't have energy, you cannot have that kind of resolve. So you must have energy, and that energy has to be calm. So in pranayama, what you do? If the breathing is very fast, then this prana, this vital energy within you, it will be vibrating, it will be fluctuating. It will not be very calm. It will be just like this. And you need it like this. It should be very, very smooth. You will feel it inside of yourself also. There is this smoothness. It is just going. And you feel? How you feel? You feel sweet. You feel so pleasantly peaceful, so beautifully joyful. And you can visualize, you can memorize, you can construct anything in your mind. Such a beautiful state. So pranayama is basically physical training that improves our ability to take very long breaths. You should breathe very, very long. Like when you breathe in, normally when people breathe in, breathe out, it is like 15 times per minute. Very fast, very fast. Yogi breathe very slow. Sometimes if you a little bit develop in meditation and yoga, then you will see, while you are taking one breath, people take already 3, 4, 5 breaths, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. And then you just wonder, how you're going to focus in that state? How you going to memorize anything? How you're going to imagine something? So you do the physical training by forcefully slowing the breath. You make it very, very slow. Breathe in and breathe out. Very, very slowly. I cannot explain the technique, because the technique in our system, we keep it as a secret technique. And it is taught from the teacher to the disciple. Of course, there are all these techniques in the internet are there. But why we do like this? Because we want to ensure that person is ready for pranayama. Of course, everybody has this self-confidence. I am ready, of course, I am ready. I also thought like that. But somehow I accepted this system that I should somehow trust the teacher. So when the teacher feels I am ready, he will teach me. In my own experience of teaching, I have done one time a mistake. I have taught person pranayama prematurely. And that has brought basically spiritual downfall of that person. He couldn't control the energy. He couldn't control the toxicity of his mind. The toxicity was already there. But somehow I thought it's okay. He is going to make it. But then he didn't. He has become extremely toxic. And then finally he went completely different direction. He became very materialistic and very, very, how to say, angry person also. So he was asking very much. I should have refused him, but somehow I was soft at that moment. So, but I learned my lesson that this practice is extremely dangerous. It is extremely, I also read it in the books before. If you read also in the books, it is everywhere this instruction, but nobody follows that instruction. Instruction is that you must be prepared for this practice, and there are so many conditions. And my guru also, he did some warnings. He said this practice is extremely dangerous for the spiritual downfall. But when the person is ready, it becomes like a nectar. So the thing is that when you increase the level of your energy, that energy powers you up. So if there is this toxicity inside, that toxicity gets powered. If there is negativity in the mind, that negativity grows like anything. And the person is just becomes out of control. But if you made your mind pure, that purity, that happiness, that bliss is also growing. So that's a very, very crucial stage. And my suggestion that you should trust an acharya, you should trust a meditation teacher who is taking care, helping you to progress in meditation and not to hurry up with this practice of pranayama. So pranayama, its effect is like this. This prana gets calm. Your intellect and your memory becomes much sharper. With the practice of pranayama, I was very surprised. You know, I was doing pranayama intensely. And then just, I remember there was time that I just read like the sutras. And within one day, just all the sutras are getting memorized in my mind. No, some, you know, like you have to study and you... Everything is just there. The mind becomes so perceptive. So pranayama is very powerful for that. To develop a good memory power, to develop a good intellect. And especially to develop this ability for a long time to see your ideational world and develop and build that world. You know, it's like in meditation, certain techniques of meditation, high meditations, you do that. You see that, you need to see. And for that, pranayama is very, very important, indispensable pranayama. There is this one story. Like a minister of the king, he got somehow on the wrong side of the king, and then he put him into the jail on the big tower. So he's sitting there in the jail, the minister, and the king wants to execute him, finish him off. Then the wife came to the tower. Hey, my husband, how can I help? He says, okay, my wife, you want to help? Tomorrow bring one cockroach, a little bit of honey, one silk thread, one small rope, and one big rope. So she brought like this next day. And then he said, okay, you put honey on the mustaches of the cockroach. It will smell and it will go. And then put the silk thread towards the cockroach and the small rope towards the silk thread and the big rope towards the small rope, to the small rope. So then the cockroach goes with the silk thread very light, and the minister catches the cockroaches, and then he takes the silk thread, and with the silk thread slowly, 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 slowly pulls, takes the little bit bigger thread, little small rope. And with that small rope, he pulls and brings the big rope. And then brings all the instruments for escape, cut the cell, the grid, and then run away. So in this story, minister is the soul. And prana, the breathing, is silk thread. Prana is the small thread. And the mind is the big rope. So by controlling the breath, you control the prana, that energy which is within you, the life energy that vibrates. So you bring that vibration, you calm it down. So in that way, your mind also becomes very calm. And your mind becomes very continuous. It's not broken like this. It's just going. You develop the ability to do dhyan, to continuously contemplate. So finally, you control the mind. And with that mind, if you control the mind, you are free. So this is the practice of pranayama. Very beautiful, very nice. When you do pranayama, you feel very supercharged. You feel like, wow. I am powerful. I feel very good. And then also you feel calm, and you feel your ability to concentrate grows. But it is dangerous also. It is very dangerous. If you have some bad thought in your mind during the pranayama, that thought gets amplified like anything. And then for next few 3 days, 2-3 days, that thought is still very powerful. It still affects your mind. It comes into your mind. So, normally I will teach pranayama after 2 years of regular meditation, once the person is very prepared. Also, there are some meditation to strengthen the spiritual centers like chakras. So, after doing that and doing basic meditation, then the person, student comes for pranayama, I teach pranayama, like that. Today, in every yoga center, you can learn pranayama. To me, it's very crazy. I just feel it is very responsible, because you develop not good qualities through that. Anyhow, it is like that. I do not advise to learn immediately, but in the first personal lesson of meditation, the prana, the breathing, is connected with the repetition of mantra. So you repeat the first syllable of the mantra while you're breathing in, and repeat the second syllable of the mantra while you're breathing out. So in that way, mantra controls the breathing. And since you want to be focused and you want to repeat mantra very, very slowly, you want to breathe also very slowly. So your breath becomes very, very slow. Sometimes people come and they say, "Dada, I breathe too slow in meditation. I'm afraid that I may die." No, you will not die. You breathe as much as you need. So when your body and mind becomes calm, you breathe very slowly. One friend of mine, he was training himself in pranayama. So he came to such level, he 1.5 hour he would do pranayama, and in that 1.5 hour he would do 16 breath cycles. So you can imagine, very, very slow breath. And then I was asking him, "Dada, did you feel anything special? Any special effects from meditation?" He said, "Yes. Wherever I focus within my body, that subtle portion of the body gets unfolded." So he was describing you all the chakras, everything, which is normally not available for like normal practitioners. It's like very advanced type of yoga. For very, very senior practitioners, this is available. So, but he was describing without actually reading in the books, he was describing just from his experience these things. So that was very interesting. So, and then he was really like, encyclopedic mind. You ask him anything, he will say. And then, "Dada, how you have such a good memory?" He said, "Yes, I'm meditating." So that was always, I was always so impressed. It's just, he was kind of demigod for me. I was looking like, what is this? This man knows everything. How is it possible? Of course, I was very young and I was really getting impressed. I didn't see people like that. So pranayama really helps in that. It helped me. Few things helped really me. I mean, everything has helped, but few things increased my clarity of mind very much. One is pranayama, another one is chakra meditation, which is also very powerful and also quite dangerous practice. But with the proper instruction and proper preparedness, you can do that. So I remember that kind of stark contrast. When I was young, my mind was like a cloud, very, very, very hazy, very unclear. And when I started to do this, like in half a year of this practice, just it was feeling like I came out of the cloud and everything just became so clear. And everything just became so easy. As if I understand everything and I can do anything. That was a powerful feeling, very nice feeling. So, yeah, pranayama is very good, very powerful, very important also. And the beginning of the pranayama, just you breathe slowly. And especially you learn the personal lesson of meditation and you breathe the mantra, first syllable in, first syllable out. That's already a big pranayama. And in asana also, when you do asana, there is this regulation of the breath. Let's say you're bending down and you're breathing out. And then you hold your breath for 8 seconds. Then you're breathing up. So that's one kind of pranayama mixed with asana together. And that brings your prana into very, very nice and calm state. Yeah, okay. In the next video, we talk about pratyahara, pratyahara yoga. Write about pranayama if you have any experience, if you... Did you feel about the effects that I'm talking here? And yeah. Namaskar.